Jack, how you doing? Hey, Liz, come here. Hi, Jack.
Hi, Jack.
Well, you're probably on airplane right now, heading to the Cayman Islands. It's April 28th, and it's your 30th birthday. So we put together a short video that you can enjoy on the plane. But we thought I would take a second and tell you what it was like the day you were born. April 28th, 1986, you were born at 1:17 a.m., Now, we went up to the hospital on Sunday, April 27th, and Liz, what was going on Sunday, April 27th?
Oh, we were at a brunch with friends, and I started having labor pains that day, and after brunch, Brian and I and the girls went back home, and I said, Brian, we got to keep this going so we can have this baby soon, and so we had the girls playing in the backyard, and Brian and I played catch all afternoon.
It was a beautiful sunny day. Obviously, we were in San Ramon, California, where we had lived for a couple of years. Addie and Mallory were already born, and we were in the backyard playing catch so that the contractions would continue, and it did. So we headed to the hospital. What time did we head to the hospital?
About 7 o'clock. Brian took the girls over to our babysitter, Jackie's, and she took care of them, and we went to Walnut Creek, drove up there.
What's the name of the hospital?
John Muir Hospital.
On Ignacio Valley Boulevard.
Yeah. Turned off, made sure we went through a drive-thru.
I was hungry.
It was not a jack-in-the-box, but we did go through a drive-thru so Dad could eat something on our way. So we did that, and that's a true story.
And so then we get to the hospital, and Mom was in contractions, and they put a heart rate monitor on her, and they noticed that your heart rate was a little irregular, so they made you stay on your back, I think, or no, on your side.
No, on my side. If I laid on my back, your heart would get... The rhythm would get all funky, so they made sure I stayed on the side. And actually, it went quite quickly because 4 hours later, we were in the delivery room with you.
Yep. And the cord was wrapped around your neck, we found out, Jack. That is why your heart rate was irregular. Mom had to be concerned about where she was laying because your heart rate would slow down. So when you were born, you came out really quickly. And as your mom will tell you, the doctor was turned around, I think looking back at me, and the nurse is a doctor, and what happened?
Well, she actually caught you coming out, and she was yelling at, well, calling for the doctor to help because the cord was around your neck, so he came over and quickly took the cord around.
But the funny story is, because Mom worked as an electric technician, while she was at work, she had a test done, and we knew we had a little boy. They told us we had a little boy. And obviously, we had two girls before that. So as Mom is in the bed there giving birth to you, the doctor goes, at a girl, talking to your mom, and Mom leans up and goes, it can't be a girl, it's a boy. And I said, take it easy, it's a boy. I was saying, at a girl to you. So
I remember Brian kept pushing me back down. No, Liz. He said, at a girl, it's not a girl, it's a boy. And you were definitely a boy, that's for sure.
So 1:17 a.m. you were born, Jack. We were very excited. We call our entire family back home in Indiana, even though, what time is it back home in Indiana at the time?
It was really early.
3, 4, 5 in the morning.
Yeah.
Woke up everybody, told them how happy we were to have a little baby boy, Jack Doherty Lernahan. So that's the story of the birth, Jack.
So you should know the facts, but I think the biggest compliment, Jack, is to say the best part of anybody's life was the day you came into their life, and that's how Brian and I feel about you, so... Take that as the biggest compliment you've ever gotten.
Very proud of you, Jack. Now,
yeah.
Enjoy the video and enjoy the flight, and we will see you in the game.
Oh, we'll have so much fun. So much fun. Happy birthday, Jack.
Happy birthday, Jack.
Masterpiece. You should be rolling with me. You should be rolling with me. Ah, you're you're a real life fantasy. You're a real life fantasy. But you're moving so carefully. Let's start living dangerously. Talk to me, baby. Let's start living dangerously.
Getting my camera.
Jack, you know what? I've been watching you all year, and how do you do those horses? Do the horse for me.
Jack, do it again.
Do that again. Yeah? I like horses too, but I have reindeers up on the roof for me.
Jackie, I got something for you.
Oh, gee.
Good horse, Jack.
Jack, how old are you?
It's under the tree, honey.
How many? Three? Yeah, have you been a good boy this year?
Yeah.
Yeah? What do you want for Christmas?
I don't know.
You don't know?
You do.
Well, Santa's got a pretty good idea. How about one of those Ninja Turtles?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I was watching that show.
And are you looking for a wallet?
I'm looking for Ninja Turtles.
Ninja Turtles? How about a wallet? You got a lot of money to put in there?
No.
Huh?
I already have a wallet.
You already have a wallet? I want a horse. You want a horse?
Yeah.
No?
Jack, you want a real?
Ninja Turtles? Okay, well, hold on one second. Let's see. We probably got...
Jack!
Yeah, buddy. Watch it, Lily.
No way.
I'm gonna get you.
Go, Jack, go. Hey, Jack, do that and not to Grandma. No, you do it. Jack, you do it.
Come on, 1, 2, 3.
Yeah.
Okay, Dad, come to the fight.
Oh, you're talking good stuff. Okay, you ready? I only eat spaghetti for breakfast.
It's day bud.
Very good. Bye.
Bye. Bye.
I love you.
Don't feel the same. Last year flew by. Goodbye to the good vibes. What we thought were the best times. Nights out with the people I love. Now I'm lost in the neighborhood. Raise me, praise me, made me who I am. My father was twice the man. And now that pain's resurfacing. Brooklyn don't feel the same. Maybe I'm the one who changed or the one to blame. Another dream down the drain. And 10 more before I get on that plane. I swear I knew just what to say. The salt tip of my tongue, but I don't feel good enough for anyone. But I won't unfold, I know, cause I got this feeling. I ain't never giving up, I ain't never ever giving up my pride. I ain't never letting go, I ain't never ever gonna sell my soul. Was a good life, fell hard for the wine in France. I didn't call you back cause I was learning to dance. This is who I've become, the salt air on the tip of my tongue. wish I was good enough for anyone. No, I won't unfold. I know, cause I got this feeling. I ain't never giving up. I ain't never ever giving up my pride. I ain't never letting go. I ain't never ever gonna sell my soul.
What's going on, police officers?
Jack is too old. And Jack is going there.
Jack is going to jail? How come?
Because he's too old.
He's too old?
Yeah.
What do you think, Officer Ted?
Good.
You think he's too old?
Yeah.
Yeah. Say happy birthday, Jack.
Happy birthday, Jack. Happy birthday to Jack.
Happy birthday, dear Jack!
Happy birthday to you, Jack!
Let me see your best lunge.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear. Happy birthday to
Jack.
Happy birthday, Jack.
Yay! Hi, Jack. Happy birthday. Can you believe you're turning 30 years old? I'm really excited to start this new decade together because I think it's going to be awesome. You're probably wondering where my present is to you because I didn't give it to you this morning. But it's going to be a few days late. But Sunday, we're going to wake up bright and early and we're going to hop on a boat chartered by the good people at Slackham Charters.
and we're gonna head out to sea and try and catch some swordfish and yellowfin tuna and grouper and hopefully a whole bunch of other fish. So get excited. I love you, Jack. Happy birthday. I'm so excited to celebrate with you today and the rest of the week in the Cayman Islands. So take that glass I know you have on the plane already, and let's cheers to 30 years. Happy birthday, Jack!
Oh, yeah.